These are the two new Surface laptops for 2019. This is the 13.5-inch model, this is the 15-inch model. Now I'm gonna spend the majority of this video talking about the 15-inch one because it's the one that's most interesting to me, but it's also the one that has the most important discussion to be had around it because there's a lot of kind of information and misinformation about this particular device. So the 15-inch device starts at $1,200, and the configurations that Microsoft is advertising and kind of pushing right now are all equipped with these AMD chips. They're custom chips, they're good performers, they have good CPU and GPU performance, but the thing that casts a little bit of shade over this entire AMD Surface Laptop 3 product line is the fact that Microsoft also sells the same laptop, but it's equipped with Intel CPUs. And those are just better, like straight up, they're better products than the AMD version. The weird thing is that Microsoft doesn't even sell this better Intel version to regular customers, at least not openly. You have to be a member of like their enterprise program or like a business customer with Microsoft to even have access to this superior product. And it's not to take away from what Microsoft and AMD have created here. Like, this is a really good device, but knowing that this is a slightly inferior product than the Intel version when you're only saving $100, just, it doesn't feel right. So with the AMD version of the 15-inch Surface Laptop 3, you get about an hour less of battery life, which is, it could be significant depending on what you do, and you also get slightly worse performance across the board. Now, if you are not a student, and you don't have access to a student discount, and there's no sales going on, I would highly recommend the Intel version over the AMD every day. And I also noticed that overnight, like once I closed this thing and just let it idle with the screen off overnight, it was draining like 15%. Every night, and I'm not sure if it's a software thing or if it's like actually related to the AMD CPU, but battery life is clearly not the strong point of the AMD Surface Laptop 3. Okay, how are they overall? They're good. The design and build quality of the Surface laptops have always been good. There's something about the way they look that I've always appreciated. They don't copy anyone. It's got this distinct Microsoft Surface design aesthetic to it, and I like that. They've also added USB-C this year. All of them have a single USB-C port, and they still also have Surface Connect on the other side. It's a lightweight machine, particularly the 15-inch. Like, there's something very well balanced and just easy to hold about this machine. It's easily the best device I've ever had for like spinning a laptop. And I think most people, like, they look at this and they're like, this is a joke. It's actually incredibly well balanced and lightweight for a 15-inch device. But the reason why it is so light, or at least part of the reason why it's so light, is because the battery in the 15-inch is the same size as the battery in the 13-inch. So the bigger screen doesn't give you a bigger battery, which is unfortunate, but it does keep the weight down on this device. When you lift the lid, you get your classic 3x2 Microsoft Surface screen, and they're both good. Both the 15 and 13-inch have good screens. There's nothing I would really have to complain about these screens. They're bright, they're not like super high refresh or anything, they're just high quality screens from Microsoft. The keyboard and the trackpad are also very good. The Surface laptops have always had great input devices, and this year it's no exception. The keyboard is something I think most people will enjoy. It's got a nice layout, the keys have a good amount of travel on it without it being too spongy or too snappy, like it's a all-around solid keyboard. And the trackpad, I think this is like literally the best trackpad on a Windows laptop. The thing that makes it special, not just its size or its texture, it's the actual click mechanism. It's like this, you hear that? It's got this like nice resonance to the click. It's a good trackpad, and obviously because it's Microsoft, it takes advantage of all the Windows gestures and stuff like that. Now, the other feature they've added this year is serviceability. They've had these screws you can remove from the bottom. I'm not going to remove them from this unit. Like, you gotta peel off the rubber tabs. I'll show a clip from iFixit where they tore this thing down, but you do have access for serviceability, not so much upgradability. Like, there's only one thing that can be user upgraded, it's the drive, and even then, it's an uncommon size, but the fact that this device can be serviced at all is a nice change from the previous year and the year before that. Okay, performance real quick. These are good laptops for kind of light to average use. If you're trying to pick one up for like video editing or gaming, it's not a thing. It doesn't matter how Microsoft tries to market these things, these are designed for lighter use. The GPUs are more powerful this year, but keep in mind that the main strength of Surface laptops have always been about portability and quiet fans and not so much power. But overall, I do like what Microsoft brought this year for the Surface Laptop 3. There's all these tweaks and upgrades that they've done across this device. It's got faster drives, better Wi-Fi, it's got USB-C, fast charging off of Surface Connect, and the repairability on these devices is something that's always nice to see. But just keep in mind, if you're interested in the 15-inch device, my recommendation is Intel, but the 13-inch device, they only offered Intel. This is like an easier option if you're interested in that one. But yeah, there you have it. Surface Laptop 3. Thumbs if you liked it, subs if you loved it. See you guys next time. But for real, give me some actual thumbs if you like this video.